I'm sure a lot of you must have seen Gayatri Devi across the internet. She belonged to a royal family and was a successful political figure in India. But do you have any idea that Gayatri Devi and our former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi had a big rivalry going on between them? What exactly was the problem? What made Indira Gandhi to imprison Gayatri Devi during the emergency period? The year is 1975. This was the year the democracy of the nation was crushed. A time when people's rights were taken away, media was controlled, and anyone who spoke out was silenced. This was the time of national emergency, one of the darkest periods in the history of modern India. But what is emergency? What exactly happened during that time? Emergency is a very serious situation in which there is a restriction on the fundamental rights of the citizens. It is declared when there is a threat to the country's security, either because of war or because of external aggression or because of internal disturbances. So why did Indira Gandhi declare an emergency? She won the 1971 election and became the Prime Minister of India. But in 1975, the Allahabad High Court convicted her for election fraud and banned her from politics for 6 years. So there was only one thing to do for her to stay in power, that is declare a state of emergency. Just one day after this judgment, she didn't even meet her cabinet ministers, but went straight to the man who was the president of India back then, Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed. Without consulting major officials or asking any questions, he imposed the emergency on this country and its people. And that was followed by 21 months of autocratic dictatorship and thousands of arrests. So it was at this time in 1975, Gayatri Devi, who was belovedly called by the people as Rajamata, was arrested and sent to Tihar Jail, where she spent the next 6 months of her life. If you see, during the period of emergency, Indira Gandhi had imprisoned several people, opposition party leaders, journalists, and whoever she saw as a threat, and that includes freedom fighters as well. So all these people were charged under the Maintenance of Internal Security Act, which is also famously called as the MISA Act. So why Rajamata Gayatri Devi was considered as a threat by Indira Gandhi? Gayatri Devi was born in 1919 into a royal family as the daughter of Maharaja Jitendra Narayanan and Indira Devi, who were the rulers of the kingdom of Cooch Behar of West Bengal. She was a princess, so she had a very privileged, luxurious childhood. She met Maharaja Savai Jaiman Singh II of Jaipur when she was at the age of 12 and married him 6 years later when she was 18, and thus she became the third wife of Man Singh and the Maharani of Jaipur. She was such a rebellious woman. For example, even though she followed many formalities of the royal family, she refused to follow the Bagda system, which is a strict norm in the royal family back then. As we know already, Gayatri Devi was such a pretty woman and had a very good fashion sense. She was even listed as one of Vogue magazine's 10 most beautiful women in the world. But throughout her life, she proved the people that she was more than just a beautiful royalty. In 1962, she conducted the Lok Sabha elections from Jaipur and won by a huge majority. She had received 78% of the total votes, which is a world record margin. And the party she contested was for the Swatantra Party, which was founded by C. Rajagopalachari, and that was the primary opposition party to the ruling Congress government at that time. So what exactly went wrong and what was the issue between the two women? The thing is, Indira Gandhi and Gayatri Devi knew each other from their school days at Patapavana, a school founded by Rabindranath Tagore in Shantiniketan, West Bengal. During their time together, it's said that Indira Gandhi had significant issues with Gayatri Devi's beauty and her display of wealth, which made Indira Gandhi to hate Gayatri Devi and her royal background. Kushwant Singh, a renowned Indian author, journalist and politician, wrote in his book that Indira could not stomach a woman more good looking than herself and insulted her in parliament, calling her a bitch and a glass doll. Gayatri Devi brought the worst out in Indira Gandhi, a very petty, vindictive side. While describing Indira Gandhi and Gayatri Devi's relationship, a report from The Independent described that her presence in the parliament was to the great irritation of Indira Gandhi. While the two attended Patapavana together, Mrs. Gandhi hated princely privilege even more than her father. After Gayatri Devi's massive victory in the 1962 Lok Sabha elections, it was very evident that she was going to become a great political figure in India. 1965, even the then Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri invited Gayatri Devi to join the Congress. But she declined the offer as she had contested the election with an anti-Congress agenda. Also in 1971, after a long legal battle, the Privy Purses were abolished. Privy Purses basically was an agreement made between the princely states and the Indian government during the partition period, which agreed to pay the royal families annually in exchange for their approval to integrate with India. This obviously affected Gayatri Devi's family as well. After the emergency was announced in 1975, a series of arrests were made targeting opposition leaders, journalists, and whoever Indira Gandhi perceived as her enemy. At that time, Gayatri Devi was in Mumbai for her medical treatment, and she was informed that she could be arrested any time once her treatment was over. When she returned to Delhi and visited the Lok Sabha, she saw the opposition benches were simply empty. None of the opposition members were present because they all were in jail. At this time, Gayatri Devi's house was raided by the IT department and she was arrested for her alleged undeclared gold and wealth. She was not ready to simply sit even in prison. Back then, juvenile jail was also there in Bihar jail where she was imprisoned. So she arranged for slates and textbooks and herself used to teach the children over there. Not just that, she also helped set up a badminton court for the children in jail. She was a 55-year-old lady at that time, so her time in jail took a serious toll on her health. Just in a few weeks, she started developing mouth ulcer, but the prison authorities didn't allow her for the dental treatment. She was allowed to get it treated only after 3 weeks. As she was already suffering from gallstone, she became too weak. After 6 months in Tihar jail, she was released on a parole on a number of conditions which remained in force until 1977 elections when Indira Gandhi was defeated. After her release, she wrote a book, A Princess Remembers, the Memoir of the Maharani of Jaipur, an autobiography that was released in 1976. After all this, Gayatri Devi never returned to politics. In 1999, the Kuch Behar Trinamool Congress nominated Gayatri Devi for the Lok Sabha elections, but she refused to accept the nomination. 10 years apart from that, in 2009, Rajamata Gayatri Devi died after battling with paralytic lungs and lung infection. So we knew both these women, one as a powerful prime minister, one as a kind, pretty royal woman. But the rivalry between these two women might have been a shock to many of us. India remembers Indira Gandhi as a bold prime minister. But the more we dig into the emergency period, the more we get to know about her negative side. However, the story of Gayatri Devi is just one among the countless number of people who were arrested during the emergency period whose stories we may never get to hear.